Hello guys, this is Alex from Masters of Ultrasound, and today we're going to review the EagleView Pro from GuideWell. I am very pleased to announce that I will be collaborating with this company, given that they gave me this ultrasound probe and a 12% discount code, which I will link down below in the description box. Despite this, they haven't influenced in my usual impartial review with honest opinions, nor approved the video prior to publication. This has been possible because of all of your support, and thank you again.
So this is how it came directly from the package. And as you can see, the package somehow resembles kind of an Apple product. I don't know, maybe it's just the packaging from the outside or the dark colors, but I don't know, it remembers me kind of an iPhone, iPad, and so on. So if we open it, we find first the quick operation guide, which is a small book of instructions. Then we find the probe covered in this translucent plastic bag. Then we find on the bottom of the box the cable, which is a micro USB for the wireless charger. And then we find the wireless charger and a stand to put the iPhone, tablet, or whatever, or even the probe itself.
As you can see, it's a wireless, dual-head probe that connects to iOS 9 or later and Android 10 or later, smartphones and tablets. Given its multipurpose and has the ability to scan both very superficial structures with the linear probe and deeper ones with the curved one, I will compare at the end of the video some of its most remarkable features versus the butterflyiq Plus and vscan Air, the two most popular multipurpose out there in the market. It doesn't make sense to compare them with specific ones, since they are usually tailored towards a specific target and therefore they usually have higher performance in that narrower spectrum of situations, whereas these probes are able to handle a wider range of circumstances. It measures 156x60x20mm, which is the equivalent to 6.1x2.4x0.8 inches, and has a glossy finish and weighs 260 grams, equivalent to 0.6 pounds. Which lies in between the butterfly, which is heavier with 309 grams, and the vscan Air, which is lighter with 205 grams. It has an integrated battery of 4,200 mAh, and in my case, it allowed approximately 30 minutes of continued use until it overheated, and almost 3.5 hours of total scan time before recharging it. Bear in mind, this time can vary substantially based on the scan mode you use and how long the image is frozen. Their official webpage states between 3 and 5 hours of total time. Color Doppler drains battery more quickly, then the remaining imaging modes, and finally a frozen screen while doing measurements or entering patient info and so on. As I have been testing it intensely, I must admit I have used Color Doppler for quite long periods. Simply placing your EagleView device over the wireless charger that comes in the same box will recharge the battery. In my case, it required approximately 2.5 hours for a full charge, although they claim less than 2 hours in their webpage, and it cannot be used while charging. It doesn't have any port, so everything is wireless, including charging and exporting images. As I mentioned initially, it has two probes integrated in the same device, with the linear end tailored towards shallow exams, such as musculoskeletal, vascular, thyroid, lung, breast, nerves, aesthetic medicine, and interventionism in general, and the curved end towards deeper exams such as cardiac, abdomen, OB-GYN, and urology. The footprints are the usual ones of linear and curved probes, same as vscan, but contrary to butterfly. The only button it has, which switches on and off the device and freezes the image, also changes between both probes, and light indicates which one is being used currently. It is not fully waterproof, only 1 or 2 centimeters from the footprint. Video speed is 18 frames per second, linear probe is 128 elements, and probe frequencies are 3.5 MHz and 5 MHz for the curved one, arriving up to 30 cm, and 7.5 MHz and 10 MHz for the linear one, arriving up to 10 cm. Bear in mind that the cardiac preset concentrates all the ultrasound beam in the center to be able to go through the ribs and obtain an image. Because it's bigger than usual phased array card machine probes, it can be tricky sometimes to obtain some views, for example, the apical 4 chambers, because of lack of space between the bed and the patient. Now you'll see the boot up and pairing process. As you can see, it will connect through a Wi-Fi network, which has detected right now, and we're able to scan right now. So just 17 seconds. This is the main screen. As you can see, it has 15 presets for the different organs, 5 imaging modes, which are B mode, M mode, color Doppler, power Doppler, and pulse wave Doppler, and several advanced image settings, such as time gain compensation, dynamic range, focus, harmonic, and denoise, as well as the typical depth and gain. It stores the image directly in your device as a JPG or AVI, and it can also use DICOM. This has some of pros, such as not needing any cloud service to store your info nor pay any annual subscription, as well as cons, such as only having the images in the device they were taken, although you can always share them via your favorite apps, such as WhatsApp, Messages, Telegram, Email, AirDrop, and so on. Now you're going to see some recorded clips with the device and live demos, because I could say it's really good or bad, but I prefer you assess it by yourself and obtain your own conclusions. I'm going to do a live demo on myself, so you'll be able to see real life image quality. Here you're seeing a personal long axis right now. As you can see, it has really good image quality. And here you're seeing the aortic valve. Again, remember, this is not a phased array probe, it's just a convex probe that concentrates all the ultrasound beam in the middle. And now let's try to obtain a peristernal short axis, which is here. You can see the papillary muscles, here the mitral valve, and if we go a little bit up, here you can see the aortic valve. Again, it's not the optimal view since I'm sitting on a chair to record it on myself. We can also check the inferior mina cava, which is this one. Here you can see the entrance into the right atrium. And here you can see the aorta. This is the aorta, and this is the inferior mina cava. Aorta, inferior mina cava. You can see here the color Doppler on the aorta. See it right now on the inferior vena cava. Now we're going to change the preset and to see the abdomen. We'll try to see my kidneys. And here you're able to see them. You can see it has a really good image quality. Here you can see the diaphragm. This is my lung, this is my liver, and this is my right kidney. You can see differentiate between the cortex and the medulla. Again, you will see here the rest of the kidney. This is a rib in between that blocks the ultrasound. Now let's try to see the other one. And here you're seeing it. This is my spleen, and this is my left kidney. Let me obtain another time here. This is my kidney. It's in between two ribs, and it's quite complicated. Let's try to rotate the axis. And here you have. Here you have the cortex, the medulla, and the cortex as well. And this is my spleen. Now let's try to see the bladder. And you can see it there in the middle, which is full of urine right now. And now let's see my carotid artery. So we're gonna just change the preset, but first we have to click here. Now it's the linear probe, and now we can choose here the preset carotid. We put a little bit of help. And we unfreeze the image. So here you have it. This is my thyroid, and this is my carotid, and this is my jugular veins. So you can see here, if we put a long axis view, this is my carotid, and as you can see, it has a very high definition that you can see even the intima. We can put the color Doppler here, and you can see you can change the color Doppler in case you want to see it with a better view.
and we can, you can change the wall filter and the PRF and the gain. Here you're seeing the M mode. You can just freeze the image and then measure here. And we're gonna put the V mode as well. Sorry, the pulse width Doppler. You can correct the angle here. And here you're seeing the Doppler curve. Here we can freeze the image and measure. For example, let's say you want to measure velocity. You can click here and you can have the velocity 128 centimeters per second. You can also click with your finger, but you can also move it with the, so here I'm gonna move it here and you can see it's another time the same, or you can just move it with the arrows in case you don't, you have a, for example, a very wide finger. Again, we're gonna put the same view. This is my trachea, this is my thyroid, which extends laterally, and this is my carotid artery. We can just go upwards until we see the bifurcation. Wait for it. And here it bifurcates. Let's put some more gain. So here you're seeing one carotid artery, and here it bifurcates into the internal and external carotid arteries. And I'm right now submaxillar, so I'm gonna stop it here. We can put the musculoskeletal preset, and I'm gonna show you with my wrist what we're seeing. As you can see, this is the mark is here, and you can see it there. So if I put my wrist here, you can see the image quality is really good. And now I'm gonna explain you these recorded clips. This is a frame of an echocardiogram assessing septal thickness. And these are several parasternal long axes with great image quality. So you can see the endocardium is sharp, delineated, and you can see the papillary muscles on the mitral valve very clearly. This surprised me, to be honest. You can see the trabecula of the myocardium with very great detail. This is an apical four chamber. I know it's not the optimal one, but it's the best that I could obtain. I don't have very good echographic window for apical four chamber. That was an apical three chamber, and this is an M mode. And here we can see color Doppler over the aortic valve, and we can see there's no aortic regurgitation nor aortic stenosis. And a lot of you guys asked me for musculoskeletal images, so there you have it. First one was from my thigh, quadriceps muscle. The second one is going upside down from my mid-calf to the Achilles tendon. And you can see that the detail of the muscular fibers are acceptable, so I think it's really good image quality for musculoskeletal as well. These are some images that I could obtain, not videos, so you to assess the quality.
The device, which is FDA approved and CE certificated, costs $3,200 if you buy it directly. However, if you use the 12% discount code you'll find in the description box, it will cost you $2,820, which is almost a $400 discount. In case you're from Europe, this translates into less than 2,400 euros. Additionally, it has a 1.5 year warranty and does not have any annual subscription. And as usual, to sum up, let's put the pros and cons all together and compare them with the Butterfly and vscan. On the pros column, we have number 1, lowest price in the market. This is the main one. It provides comparable results to more expensive options, and here lies its greatest value. Number 2, great image quality and advanced imaging settings. Number 3, several imaging modes, which are V mode, M mode, color Doppler, pulse wave Doppler, and power Doppler. Number 4, it's aesthetic, somehow light and not clunky. And number 5, it has a long battery duration and fast charging. On the other hand, on the cons column, we find number 1, color Doppler scale up to 40 cm per second only, suboptimal for cardiac velocities. Number 2, gain adjustment is made by buttons, not with a left or right slide, which would be easier, Number three, not having the technical support of a big multinational company. And number four, which is a relative con, it has a lot of manual image quality settings. This can be daunting for inexperienced people that might prefer that an algorithm adjusted the image by itself. And now let's face the EagleView's device versus the butterflyiq Plus and vscaner that I've reviewed in the past on the channel. Here you have their reviews. I recommend you check them out as well, in case you're indecisive between them. We're gonna compare the size and weight, battery, imaging modes, image quality, advanced image settings, and price, which are the most important features for most of you. If someone wants any further detail, please let me know in the comments. Number 1. Size and weight. It lies between the vscaner and butterflyiq Plus, both in size and weight. As I mentioned earlier, it weighs 260 grams versus 309 from the butterflyiq Plus and 205 for the vscaner. Number 2, the battery. This extra weight and size versus the vscaner allows it to have a bigger battery. It has similar performance, if not better, than the butterflyiq Plus. Number 3, imaging modes. Neither the vscaner nor the butterflyiq Plus has the same amount of modes outside of the United States, with vscaner only having B-mode and color doppler, and butterflyiq Plus having B-mode, M-mode, color doppler, power doppler, and, only in the United States, pulse wave doppler. It also has additional tools such as the auto ejection fraction calculator, bladder volume calculator, needle enhancer, and biplane tool for interventionism that any other handheld device has. Number 4, the image quality. In my humble opinion, the vscaner has the best B-mode image quality, then I would say the EagleView, and then finally butterfly. This applies especially to the heart, which is what I scan the most, but can relate for the rest of the body. And number 5, the price, which is $2,820 or 2,400 euros with the 12% discount code that I left in the description box, which is POCUS12, versus the $2,999 with a lifelong option or $1,999 plus $420 per year for the butterflyiq Plus, and you'll see the equivalences in euros on the screen right now, and $4,495 for the vscaner, and you'll be able to see the equivalences in euros as well right now. The vscaner doesn't have any additional subscription either, same as the EagleView. I must say that here in the ultrasound world there aren't any bargains regarding imaging quality. You get what you pay for, so a $7,000 device will have better image quality, and a $40,000 one even better, presumably. But with that being said, this device offers a very good image quality, settings and modes for a reasonable price. So that's it, thank you guys for watching the video until the end, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and thank you again for the support you keep giving me and fueling the channel. Remember that you'll have down below in the description box the 12% discount code, which is POCUS12, and their website. And let me know in the comments what you think about this device, if you have any additional questions, and if you want to suggest further devices to review in the channel. On to the next one, bye!